moment ago, Republicans apparently do not have the support they need. In other words, if a vote happens now, it would fail. Some Republicans pin some of the blame so far on the president. Listen to what two members of the president's own party had to say.
I'm looking for something that President Trump supports, and he's not yet indicated what measure he's willing to sign. As soon as we figure out what he is for, then I would be convinced that we were not just spinning our wheels going to this issue on the floor, but actually dealing with a bill that has a chance to become law and therefore solve the problem.
You can't blame President Trump for a broken congressional system, but we do need a better partner down at the White House.
Well, they might be pointing fingers at the president. No doubt most Republicans, as we talked to Congressman Garrett earlier tonight, are going to be blaming this on Democrats. With me now, if there is a shutdown, two CNN political commentators who know a lot about these types of negotiations, what's at stake, what can hold things up, former White House Communications Director for President Obama, Jen Psaki, and former Senator Rick Santorum. Senator Santorum, the House has voted, so all eyes now turn to the Senate. Can you just walk us through what's likely going on behind the scenes right now?
Well, I mean, they're obviously trying to get to the bill. They'll have to move to proceed, which usually the Republicans will, whether you're for or against what the House passed, the Republicans will line up and will support the leader's ability to bring up whatever bill he wants. So that should not be a big deal. And then it's just a matter of whether they can twist enough arms and get enough Republicans to show some unity. The whole idea for Republicans is to try to show solidarity,
right,
and trying to get as many people. So whether they get to 50 or 51 would be great. If they can get to a number, then they can point the finger pretty clearly at the Democrats and say, look, we put up all the votes we could to make this thing work, and the other side isn't helping us. But if they come up short, I mean, if, you know, 5, 6, 7, 10 Republicans vote no, then it's a little harder for them to make the case that they're responsibly governing.
Jen, I mean, you were part of the Obama administration during the shutdown in 2013. Does a shutdown really work out well for anybody? Because I'm guessing both sides right now are hoping the other side gets the blame.
Shutdowns are never great politics, Anderson, but there have been four. This would be the fourth shutdown in the last 25 years. Republicans have been blamed, if you look at polling, every single time because they controlled chambers of Congress. So there's no reason to believe that would be different. In this particular scenario tonight, there are four Republican senators who have said they wouldn't support this. So you're looking at a scenario where McConnell would have to get 13 Democrats on board to get to the 60, which is a very hard hurdle. But the Democrats I've spoken to, they don't want a shutdown. It's not great politics. What they want is they want to use this leverage to get the Republicans, a larger swath of them, to the negotiating table, to address DACA, to make this a longer-term spending bill. That's what they really want to get to.
But why go for everything all at once? I mean, you know, Jen, I mean, couldn't Democrats just say, well, look, we'll get the child, you know, the CHIP program, and we'll do DACA next. Is it just all about leverage?
Well, part of it's leverage, which they don't have frequently because Democrats don't control anything in Washington. But they feel they were promised a deal on DACA in December. That has not been delivered on. And they're talking, this is not just a political issue for many Democrats, it's a moral issue. You're talking about 700,000 people whose lives are hanging in the balance. And they don't trust that if Republicans say, we'll address that in February, that it will actually happen. So they feel now is the time where they need to get a deal on this.
Yeah, the problem with that, Anderson, is that the deal they put forward wasn't just about DACA. It was about 10 million folks who could, in one way or another, stay in this country indefinitely. And so if their concern was about DACA, they should have brought a bill, a compromise deal to the president that just dealt with DACA. They didn't. So, you know, they were overreaching, and they're getting their hands slapped as a result of this. So you make up the good point. Every Democrat that's voting no tonight is voting against a bill that they support. There's nothing in this bill the Democrats oppose. So you say, well, why don't you just take what everybody agrees with and then come back and get the next bite at the apple? And really, let's be honest, no one's going to negotiate an immigration bill in the next 24 hours. I mean, it's just way too complicated to do that. This really gives the Democrats a month to still have leverage. They're going to come back in a month. They're going to need another vote. They're going to have to make another compromise. Republicans are, if they're going to get Democratic votes to pass it. Now they don't have children's health insurance, if this passes, as a leverage point to get Democrats to vote for it. I don't really see the angle. And candidly, to just contradict Jen a little bit, the reason Republicans got blamed for the last shutdowns was because Republicans were demanding something other than a clean bill. The Democratic presidents wanted, or Republican presidents in some cases, wanted a clean bill, and the Congress said, no, we want to put this, there's things in here we don't like and we want out, or we want to put in there. And that's why they lost. The Democrats are now the ones doing that, and I think that puts them in real precarious situation.
Senator Santorum, you heard what Lindsey Graham had to say earlier today. Do Republicans need a better partner in the White House, as Senator Graham says?
I think he's right. I don't agree with what Lindsey's doing on immigration, but I think he's right that the president, and Mitch McConnell's right, the president needs to show more leadership of what he wants. That the as good as the optics were for the president in that meeting that that he had, he really did not provide any clarity as to what he was willing to sign and what he wasn't. He listed four things, but then was all over the place as right. to whether he would accept pieces of those things. He needs to be very clear about what he will and what he won't accept. And let's be honest, the four things the president's asking for are things that Democrats, by and large, support.
Senator Santorum, Jen Psaki, thanks very much. The House Intelligence Committee.